Hello, in this video we're going to learn a little bit about DIY captions from the ground up. This is the first video in the series. DIY Captions is a website that has various tools for making it possible to work with captions from YouTube videos. Basically, there are three kinds of captions, you might say. There are the closed captions that humans edit and publish to go with videos so that you can follow along, just as if you were watching captions in a DVD. There are translations into other languages. One of the words for that is subtitles, or translated subtitles. And then there are what are called auto-generated or automatic captions. Those are the captions that Google software produces without any human intervention, based on an analysis of the audio of a video, looking for indications as to what words are spoken. And we're going to talk about how to use DIY captions to turn automatic captions into professional closed captions, or even to translate them into subtitles. The way this all works is you go to YouTube and you find a video that hasn't got captions, but it has automatic captions. And here's how you know this. If you come to a video, this happens to be a TEDx talk that was published today. Suppose you were the person whose job it was to produce captions as quickly as possible after this video came out. How quickly could you get captions produced for this video? Well, it depends on exactly what level of quality you're talking about, but I would contend you could do it within one day, and that's what you're going to learn how to do following these video lessons. Let's go ahead and play this video a little bit, just in the middle here.
Well, apart from the fact that this time I knew for sure I wasn't crazy.
If you were a typical transcriptionist, you would have some kind of Word document or word processor document where you would start the video, you would type what she says, and then you would stop the video and catch up, and then continue that process until you had the entire video transcribed. But Google is doing sort of the same thing for you. So let's try to take advantage of that if we can, and that's the whole idea behind DIY captions. So within a video, there are certain options that you have at your disposal. You can turn annotations on or off. You can make a video autoplay. You can set the speed to go faster or slower. You can change the video quality, the resolution. But you can also interact with what are called subtitles and closed captions. Right now, the only option we have for this video is English auto-generated. That just simply means that nobody has bothered to actually produce professional captions for this video yet, but Google has taken the liberty of trying to help out the deaf, the hard of hearing, and people who might not be able to understand spoken English very well, but who can read it better than they can understand it. One way you can turn them on is to click right here, and you'll put a check mark there, and you'll see this appear up at the top, English auto-generated captions. Another simple way to turn them on and off is simply to click the CC button right here, which of course stands for closed captions. So one way you can get this in to work on it would be to grab the URL and then go to the DIY Captions homepage. Takes us to this page. Now, if we're just trying to get the text of what was said in that video, very easy to do. Just paste the URL. In fact, this is all we really need. So if you ever have a URL that for some reason tricks this website into not being able to get what you want, just try to find that 11-character ID right there and put it into the box and it'll work just fine. So we're going to click on Get Text. That takes us to this page here. The only set of captions or subtitles that are available right now is the English auto-generated captions, or the English automatic captions. So there's the text. We can click into it. We can press Control A, and then we can right-click and copy, or we can press Control C. And characters per second is very low. She is a slow speaker, so this is going to be very easy to do for a new beginner kind of person. And this is why I recommend that if you're trying to learn the system, I highly recommend that you use TEDx talks as your fodder for practicing, because it's not quite as intimidating. The people tend to speak slow in TEDx videos. We're going to go back, get the URL again, go back to the DIY Captions homepage, We're going to scroll down to this box here where we can open this up in the DIY Captions Transcription Pad, which is going to give us an interface that's somewhat like WordPad or Notepad, but you have an integrated video to go with it and some buttons for backing up and going forward. And there are also some keystrokes that you can read about if you click on the menu when it comes up. There'll be a help reference that lets you learn some of the keystrokes. So what we're going to do right now is go back to this here, right click, copy, come back to here, and paste. And now we're going to use the transcription pad to produce a clean transcript of the video. And we're using the automatic captions that Google has transcribed using software and computers and artificial intelligence going on. And it's really pretty impressive what they've got going here. And it's especially impressive when you consider that all of this is free. So here we go. We're going to click this button to start the video, or we can click this to start and stop the video. But this will always take us to the very beginning. We do have music, in fact. Google's right about that. And we do have applause. Google's right about that. But we probably wouldn't want to have music twice there, so we'll take that out.
When I was little, I believed that magic was real. Here are two pictures.
All right, so what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to break this up by sentences by simply putting in a blank line every time a new sentence begins.
Two pictures of me from my childhood. I believed everything was possible. I had so many dreams. I wanted to live on the moon like a little prince in a little cozy house and gaze down on this cute little world. And I really believed that was possible. And when I looked at the stars at night, I was waiting for a miracle that would make it possible. Now, I would like to tell you about a miracle that happened in my life, but not the one I ever expected.
Even if a person had no access to the audio of this video, once you do this, assuming that you've corrected any words that were wrong, it turns out that every one of these words is accurate. So we have 100% accuracy of word recognition up to this point. It would be very simple to hand this off to a skilled editor, and they would do all the necessaries. They would say, well, let's make that a capital W. Let's put capital letters at the beginning of each of these words, each of these sentences. And this is the typical way you would work in a typical word processor, because in a typical word processor, you just have to delete the first letter that you want to capitalize and then retype it as a capital letter. But DIY Captions is trying to help you out here by saying, well, come on, a computer can uppercase a letter in one keystroke rather than you having to do two. Because, I mean, if you look at what we're having to do, you have to delete the letter I, that's one keystroke, then you have to move your hand over and hold down the shift key and then type in the same letter to make a capital. Well, in DIY Captions, it just so happens that the F9 key will do the same thing. So let's take advantage of that a little bit.
12 years old. One day, I was in school.
All right, so we're going to pause. Start a new line. F9.
In school, playing basketball.
And we're just going to repeat that process for like 10 sentences. F9.
I started running towards the net, and suddenly...
So she's actually saying toward, even though she thinks she's saying forward.
Suddenly everything went black. My heart...
So we pause with F1. We press F9 to capitalize that. F1 to start
my
again.
My heart started to beat 250 beats per second, and to my shock, I fell down on the curb.
Okay, so we're going to help her out here. She's playing basketball, so she's playing on a basketball court. She fell down onto the court. She could just as easily have said on the floor. But, okay.
Later, I found out that if my heart rate hadn't slowed down within a few minutes, I would have died.
And Okay, now you saw me just move from word to word to word with the blinking cursor. Some people call that a caret, some people call it an insertion point, but we're going to call it cursor for the purpose of this video. So F9 again. So now we're halfway to having good sentences there. Basically, the other thing you have to add would be a period at the end of each sentence, assuming it's not a question, assuming it's not using an exclamation point. So just click, we'll take out the spaces we left behind, click, period, click, backspace, period. And as you can see, we now have something even closer to a professional transcript. The only thing missing now really is commas. So let's just take a look through here and just decide where we would put commas. When I was little, comma, here are two pictures of my childhood. I believed everything was possible. I had so many dreams. I wanted to live on the moon like a little prince in a little cozy house and gaze down on this cute little world. No commas necessary. And I really believed that was possible. And when I looked at the stars at night, comma, I was waiting for a miracle that would make it possible. Now, some people would put a comma there. I would like to tell you about a miracle that happened in my life, comma, but not the one I ever expected. It all started when I was 12 years old. One day, comma, I was in school playing basketball. I started running toward the net. You could put a comma. And suddenly everything went blank. My heart rate started to beat 250 beats per second. We could add the word at here to make it a little more grammatically correct. And to my shock, so we could put a comma here, to my shock, comma, I fell down the court. Now you may disagree with where the commas should go. And commas are kind of a subjective thing. Different people have different rules for commas. You do what you think is best. The purpose of this isn't to teach you where commas go. It's to teach you how easy it is to put them in if you want them and how quickly you can do them if you learn the shortcut keys that have been designed to make the insertion of such punctuation marks faster. So if you look at what we just did there, we now have like 1 minute of clean video. Now this is a 19 minute video and we're not going to do 19 minutes of cleanup in this tutorial. But as you can see, we didn't type just about anything. We've just used our mouse. We put some blank lines in. You could bring those back together if you wanted into paragraphs if your client preferred paragraph styling. What we've got here is pure sentences, sentence, 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 blank line, and perfectly punctuated. And this is a completely professional transcript. And you have learned how to do that using Transcription Pad in the quick duration of this short video. And you will learn even cooler things if you'll watch the rest of the videos that come after this video. So hang with us. And thanks for watching this. Please subscribe and share and like, and let's try to get millions of people around the world understanding how easy it is to turn Google and YouTube's automatic captions into professional transcripts that you can actually sell to clients for profit. Thanks for watching.